My name is Kongjian Yu. I'm speaking from Beijing. So even we are so distant apart, but we share the same challenges. Climate change, of course. Now that means flood everywhere and drought at the same time. So what's the solution? The conventional solution is to build a stronger and a more powerful concrete dam and dikes to accumulate water, but also accumulate higher risk. Channelize the river, use concrete to speed up the flow, but at the same time, speed up the next drought. And we build a higher and higher flood wall to fight against the flood, but it fails and it will fail. As you can see in New Orleans, in China's Zhengzhou cities and everywhere, they fail, they will fail. Meanwhile, because we consume so much energy, so much concrete and steel, so we worsen our climate. So I'm talking the alternative. The alternative is nature-based ecological infrastructure. I call it green sponge, you know, the sponge you use in your kitchen, which is infrastructure for the city. I call the sponge city, which is a nickname for resilient city. Its philosophy is to retain water at its source, slow down its flow, and be adaptive at the sink, which is totally opposite to the conventional solution of gray infrastructure. In one sense, Sponge City was inspired by our Bostonian hero, Fred Law Olmsted, who planned landscape as infrastructure. And in the other sense, it was inspired by the ancient wisdom of farming in adaptation to monsoon climate. Climate change is nothing new for those who live in the monsoon region. We have to revive this kind of ancient wisdom, such as terracing the slope, pounding the ground, islanding the wetland or the lake in order to make the land cultivable, productive, livable. So for over 20 years, I have been inspired by this kind of technology and upgraded those and have built over 500 projects plus in more than 200 cities in China and in other parts of the world to heal our planet. Here is an example. In the city of Nantong, which suffers monsoon flood every year, we transform an 130-acre coal ash dumping ground into a floating forest. Use this pond and dike and islanding technique that can regulate 2 million cubic meters of stormwater or 1 million cubic meters of stormwater in some of the year. Meanwhile, this place now become a habitat for migrant birds and a beautiful park for the people nearby. So that's a resilient city, can be produced by such a simple technique we learn from the ancient farming technique. Now this was featured just a couple months ago by the MIT Technology Review. Here is another example. Inspired by ancient wisdom of farming, a green sponge was created in the central part of the city Sanya, which is a monsoon city, suffering urban flood every year. With terracing the ground, pounding and islanding the wetland, and create a really green sponge right in the middle of the city that solves the problem in the area 10 times as much as the park itself. Meanwhile, we create a beautiful park for people to enjoy most of the year and a habitat for the birds. Similarly, just a year ago, we designed a forest park in the middle of Bangkok. Here and brownfield of factory making tobacco. And we just by cut and fill, create islands and like that function as a sponge, solves the problem of urban inundation and create a beautiful park right in the middle of the city in just 1 year. And it's now become a new cultural icon for the capital. So most of the urban rivers in the past decades in China has been channelized like this one. And back 20 years ago, we de-channelized the river, recover the riverfront, and turn the river into a resilient green sponge that allow water to slow down and the nutrients, the pollutant can be removed and also make this accessible for the people in the city. Similarly, even bigger river dam like that, a huge flood wall, strong, very powerful. We build it to protect the city from being flooded, but the flood problem can never get solved. So use nature-based solution, we remove concrete, terrace in the riverbank, and transform this into an ecological riverbank, to allow water to come into the city and make the city become adaptive, resilient city. So that's during the monsoon season. Meanwhile, it is a beautiful park for people to use. Now we know climate change. Does the sea level rise means we have to build a higher and a stronger flood wall? Maybe not. The alternative and probably more resilient way is to create a nature-based buffer. In this particular case, we successfully convinced the city to remove the concrete wall and let the salty water from the ocean to meet the fresh water from the upper stream to create an ideal habitat for mangrove to get established. In just 3 years, we create a beautiful spongy park that full of birds and also a beautiful park for people to use. Now, I'm talking not about just a piece of park, a piece of green space. I'm talking about the transformation of the whole infrastructure we have built today based on the gray concrete and steel. For example, here in the city of Haikou in Hainan Island, suffering monsoon flood every year and polluted, and the whole river, which is about 15 miles long, was treated as a gray infrastructure. People keep dredging the river, pave the river with concrete, and build the flood wall higher and higher, but never get the problem solved. So we take another way. The alternative is actually remove the concrete wall and terrace the riverbank and give the water more space and let the construct wetland along the riverbank to filtrate the urban runoff, to clean it, and also create this waterfront for people to enjoy. Meanwhile, create a beautiful habitat for biodiversity. So more than ever, we have to think the way we build our cities, the way we treat water and nature, and even the way we define civilization. Sponge city and sponge planet is a holistic and nature-based solution to protect and restore ecological infrastructure and make wise use of nature's surfaces. Now, these surfaces are free for the benefit of the planet and the welfare of the people. While right now, politicians are negotiating for a carbon neutral globe in the UN climate conference in Egypt. But remember, we have to really have a big vision, to think like a king. Now, this is a legendary king, the Yu the Great, who had the vision of healing the earth and living with nature. But also remember, we have to act like a peasant who are able to transform the global surface down to earth, even use very simple tool. Thank you so much.
Is your government a competitive advantage or competitive disadvantage to you doing these big ideas?
I have this book published in English called The Letter to the Leaders of China. I should have the book also, The Letter to the Leaders of America. We share the same community. We have the only globe. So I don't care about, you know, everyone should act like peasant to do something down to earth. I will say we can just fix the globe much easier.
Let me ask you this. So Boston has our Grand Canyon. We have a bunch of wonderful islands, 36. It's a national park. Do you see us doing anything creative with that? Because I feel like you see things in a dimension that no one sees. Like, how can we harness some of your brilliance in the ecosystem in the Boston region?
Boston is vulnerable to the sea level rise. But luckily enough, Boston have so many islands that protects the city from getting surge. But eventually, you will suffer from the flood. And we should continue the legend, the legacy of Olmsted, and create an ecological or strengthen an ecological infrastructure that will function as a sponge, or makes the region more resilient. And right now it's not enough. I would say right now it's not enough. But we already have this legacy, and we just continue and use very simple tool. We should not trust the industrial technology. We should keep suspicious what we have today. Those technology built upon the mild climate. Now the climate change, and you have to change everything. Yeah. So that's why I have this book here. You say everything needed to be changed. That's, I think.
I want to see you come and do something for Boston. Your designs are so beautiful, and the city needs more beauty, and it also needs the protection from the floods that are definitely coming. It's amazing work you're doing. Thank you.
I mean,
thank you so much.
Well, plus one to that. I mean, I think if I've ever seen an example of like how human intervention, you know, the meaning the walls and things like that that you show that we have built that we need to replace, you know, take down the earth, and then the beauty and the fast replacement that nature comes in and brings us. I mean, everyone needs to see this talk, and every city needs to adopt this practice. Thank you so much.